And how central do you think that was to the loss?
I thought that was extremely detrimental to us trying to compete and win a quarter, win a half, win a ball game. I just think, you know, like I've been saying it all season, those self-inflicted wounds that we have to clean up, and they come back and rear their ugly heads sometime. And we'll make some ground, make some traction in terms of alleviating those type of mistakes. And then, boom, out of nowhere, you know, it's just one of those nights where it really spilled over. And, you know, it was up and down the lineup. It's not just one particular person. It's up and down the lineup. So we take care of the ball. Who knows? At the end of the day, you know, we hold them 17 points in the fourth quarter. That's how we have to play every quarter. That's how we have to start the game. Miami's going to force you, you know, to play at a level that may be a little uncomfortable for guys who are not physical or, you know, competitive. But it's sort of like the identity that we're trying to create here and the type of players we want in here. Guys are going to go out and dig their heels in the mud and really not afraid to get dirty and get in your chest and just be physical and competitive all the way across the board. And my hat's off to them. You know, I've been in the East now for the last 9 years, and now, you know, coming back over here and playing them, it was just the same old Miami Heat, you know what I mean? Just that hard hat and lunch pail. And they did a really good job of, you know, taking advantage of those opportunities when we turned the ball over, getting themselves extra possessions, especially early in the first half. And they had 6 offensive rebounds in the first quarter alone. So it's another learning lesson, something else we get to look at and continue to work at and try to get better at.
Darvin, before the game, you're talking how Orlando was, you know, everyone's kind of kicking in and everyone's sharing the load tonight, especially in that first half. The LeBron on-off numbers were kind of striking, and you know, every time he was checking out, Miami was pulling ahead. The guy, a lot of your supporting guys got there, but what do you kind of say to those guys on a night where it just seemed to take some time for them to catch up there and pitch in?
I mean, just slow down and try to trust one another. You know, that's the biggest thing. To try to, you know, play good team defense. Everyone get hits. You know, don't just think because one of your teammates has their body on a player when a shot goes up that you don't have to hit that player as well. You know, and try to secure a rebound and hold them to one possession. And then offensively, just trust the execution. You know, we think we have, you know, Miami does a great job in thinking that you have an advantage. And then next thing, you know, here come one or two extra bodies behind your initial defender that's on the ball. So what you thought you had, you find yourself in a compromising position once you think you've beaten the guy that's guarding you. So, and then that forces you to make the right play. And there was a lot of times I thought we held the ball maybe 1 or 2 seconds too long, or 1 or 2 dribbles too long. And we didn't play downhill enough. In the second half, specifically in the fourth quarter, I thought we played downhill a little bit more. We didn't settle. We tried to attack the basket. And, you know, it is what it is. Again, we'll learn from it. We just have to learn how to not, you know, and no one, everyone means well. You know, they're trying to do their part to fix the situation if the game is not going, you know, our way. It's just when you get that mindset of wanting to fix something, fix it with your teammates. Don't try to fix it by yourself.
Darvin, you went to Juan in the start of the fourth quarter. I think he might have played the whole fourth. What did he give you guys? And when you talk about kind of things like sacrifice, doing things for your teammates, is that stretch kind of, does that exemplify kind of what you're looking for from Absolutely. Supporting players?
Absolutely. I mean, he didn't score, but he had 7 huge rebounds in 13 minutes. Yeah. And 3 offensive. He got his extra possessions. He covered up some holes defensively. He was able to switch off on certain guys, move his feet, stay in front of perimeter guys, get low, get in the stance, in the post, and, you know, try to battle with Bam, which is no easy task at all. But yeah, just that guy that's going to, you know, put his head down and do whatever what's needed of him or what the team needs in terms of getting extra possessions, being a physical presence, battling, guarding different positions, setting great screens, rolling, running hard, you know, in transition, getting back in transition.